dark side's calling out of the misery. She'll never know just how I feel. From out of the shadows she walks like a dream. Make me feel crazy, make me feel so mean. And nothing gonna save me from the love that's flying.
So this is the hotel room that Wendell Newton had passed away in the cult classic, Eddie and the Cruisers. Right now it's numbered 127, but in the movie it's numbered 27. As you can see, it's an Econo Lodge, but these buildings are famous for being the ebb tide in Summers Point. They still stand. And I have just spent a night in here. Simple, clean. And the pool is still here. Actually, the pool is really appetizing, for sure. Let me take a walk over here. The ebb tide sign, of course, is gone. And that's where the drummer had went in. He hopped in that window because Wendell would not open the door, and he found Wendell in the bathtub.
Wendell.
That was August of 1963.
Died of a heart attack. He was only 37.
Sign is gone. Right across the street, it's a place called the Windjammer. And if you look down, you can see the now newer 9th Street Bridge. We see here, you're in Summers Point, Summers Point Marina. This marker says Bay Avenue Nightlife, Gateway Casino, Tony Mart's, Bay Shores, Steel's Ship Bar were all located at this end of Bay Avenue. They made up the musical heart of the Bayfront, from the big bands and marathon dances of the 30s and 40s to the rock and roll greats of the 50s and 60s. We take a look to the right, and this is where the famous Tony Mart's And that's where you saw Eddie and the Cruisers pull up in the movie. Right down that road. It's now called the Beach House Bar and Grill. Totally different building, but this is the spot of the former Tony Mark.